Hi everyone. Today we are going to discuss about tissue systems, part 1. Under this we can discuss about epidermal tissue system and fundamental or ground tissue system. Very first we have to know what is tissue system. In higher plants, several tissues work together in form of a unit to perform a particular special function. These tissues have the same origin. Such tissues form a system which is called tissue system. On the basis of their structure and location of tissue, tissue systems are categorized into three different types by the scientist Sachs. Tissue systems are three types, such as epidermal tissue system, ground or fundamental tissue system, and vascular tissue system. Again, I am repeating, tissue systems are three types. Number one, epidermal tissue system. Number two, fundamental tissue system. And number three, vascular tissue system. The very first one, epidermal tissue system. The epidermal tissue system forms the outermost covering of the plant body. It is made up of elongated, compactly arranged cells which form a continuous layer. Epidermal cells are parenchymal cells. This epidermal tissue system includes epidermis and its related structures. Example, root hairs, trichomes, stomata, and bulliform cells, etc. This epidermal tissue system developed from protoderm. Epidermis shows epidermal appendages like epidermis, stomata, trichomes, and root hair. I am repeating again, epidermal tissue system contains epidermis, stomata, trichomes, and root hair. Number one, epidermis. Epidermis derived from a Greek word epiderma. Epi means upon, derma means skin. The epidermis of most of the plant organs is uniseriate, which means unilayered or single layered, which means composed of single layer of epidermal cells, but in some cases it may be multilayered or multiseriate. Example, ficus, nerium, peperomia. Each cell of epidermis has a large central vacuole and peripheral thin cytoplasm. They may contain anthocyanin pigments, tannins, oils, and crystals, etc. The outside of the epidermis is often covered by the waxy thick layer called cuticle. Cuticle is absent in roots. The second one, stomata. Stomata are minute apertures in the epidermis. Each aperture is bounded by two kidney or bean shaped cells in dicotyledons called guard cells. Dumbbell shaped guard cells are present in grasses or monocotyledonous plants. Guard cells contain chloroplasts. Inner wall of guard cell is thickened than outer wall of guard cell, which means inner wall of guard cell is thickened and outer walls are thin. There are different numbers of cells of variable size in the epidermis around the guard cells are called subsidiary cells. Stomatal apparatus composed with guard cell, stomatal pore, and subsidiary cells. When guard cells become turgid, that time they may open and forms a pore between them, which is called stomatal pore. Stomatal aperture composed with guard cells, which contains chloroplasts, subsidiary cells, and stomatal pore. Dicotyledonous plants contains bean or kidney shaped guard cells. Monocotyledonous plants or grasses contains dumbbell shaped guard cells. And one more important thing is, inner walls of guard cells are thick than outer walls of guard cells, which means inner walls are thickened, outer walls are thin. Functions of stomata. Stomata regulate the process of transpiration and gases exchange in plants. Stomata are absent in roots, underground parts, and submerged hydrophytes. Let's see the diagrammatic representation of stomata. The first diagram shows stomatal aperture in dicotyledonous plants with kidney-shaped or bean-shaped guard cells. The second diagram shows the monocotyledonous plant stomatal aperture. Why? Because it contains dumbbell-shaped guard cells. Third one, trichomes. On the stem, the epidermal hairs are called trichomes. These trichomes are usually multicellular. They may be branched or unbranched and soft or stiff. Functions of trichomes. The trichomes help in protection, dispersal of seeds and fruits, and preventing water loss due to transpiration. Trichomes are multicellular, hair-like, branched or unbranched structures coming out from epidermis of stem. They may be soft or stiff. Fourth one, root hair. The root hairs are unicellular, elongation of the epidermal cells. The thin wall is made up of cellulose and pectic materials. Root hairs are endogenous in origin. The functions of root hairs. Root hairs plays an important role in anchoring the plant body in the soil, besides absorbing water and mineral solution from it. Root hairs are unicellular, thin, delicate structures which helps in the absorption of water and minerals from soil. The second type of tissue system is ground or fundamental tissue system. All tissues except epidermis and vascular bundles constitute the ground tissue. It consists of simple tissues such as parenchyma, colenchyma and sclerenchyma. Parenchyma cells are usually present in cortex, pericycle, pith or medulla and medullary rays, in the primary stems and roots. In leaves, the ground tissue consists of thin-walled chloroplast-containing cells and is called mesophyll. The most abundant tissue system in plant body is fundamental tissue system and composed with all types of tissues like parenchyma, colenchyma and sclerenchyma. Up to here, the epidermal tissue system and ground or fundamental tissue system is completed. In next video, I will explain about vascular tissue system. Thank you very much.